Congratulations, Father. The prisoner has been waiting for you.
House.
His calm and quiet father slept well.
The execution is set.
Within an hour, exactly at 6.
May I see him now?
Certainly, I'll bring him out.
Here?
Yes, it's permissible. One moment. Father Lim is here.
Father?
Pablo.
Father? I've been expecting you, Father. May I wish?
None, my son. I tried. God knows so much.
I understand, Father.
Sir Gonzalez, any last request you wish to make? I mean, any kind of food will be committed.
Can I ask anything?
Anything within reason.
A bottle of whiskey. Can I ask for a bottle of whiskey?
Whiskey?
You see, Father, I could not afford to drink it before. I get to use the cheap Ginebra and Tuba. I've always dreamed of being able someday to drink whiskey, a whole bottle.
Anything more?
Yes, 2 glasses.
Isn't there anything you want with whiskey?
Yes, make it 3 glasses. We'll all drink.
What I mean, Mr. Gonzalez, is there any food you might want?
Food? No, nothing more.
Very well.
Pardon, has my aunt arrived?
Not yet, but there is a young girl.
A young girl?
Dressed in black.
Christina?
Your...
Shall I let her in?
No, not yet. I let you.
If you want anything, Father, I shall be just out of the door.
Pablo!
Forgive me, Father. I was thinking.
Take a seat. What were you thinking of, my son?
I was thinking. I can't believe it. That I would be here to be condemned an hour at the age of 24.
Be calm, Pablo. I went to see the governor for a retreat. A few days more at least. But he said he couldn't do anything.
Father, do you think?
Yes.
What you said last night, that God could forgive me after all I've done.
My son, Christ has said that if your sins are scarlet, they shall be as white as snow if you ask His forgiveness.
Father,
God's mercy is infinite, my son.
No, I can't, not yet.
As you wish, Father.
If my mother had only taught me to believe and to pray, but she never did. That's why I'm here.
Your mother's pity.
Yes, but I hope I never see her again.
Why?
What's the use, Father? It's a long story.
While entering the prison gate, I noticed a woman standing on the sidewalks and looking towards the cell. It could be a mere coincidence, but a certain resemblance.
Is she tall?
Yes, rather. And wearing a colored dress.
Curly hair?
Now that I come to think of it. Yes, her face was all...
covered with too much paint?
Wearing earrings and bracelets.
That's her all right. I wonder why she's here.
Don't you expect a mother to see her son?
I don't want to see her!
Pablo, what you told me a moment ago, that your mother never taught you to believe and to pray, is that the reason? You don't want us here?
That father, and more. But let's not talk about it. I want to rest a little. I'm tired. A little nervous. I hope you don't mind it.
No. No, of course. You should be done for a while. You want me to go?
No, not yet, father. Will you read me something? My heart is so heavy. Perhaps your book will give me some comfort.
I have a book here. Tempis, the following advice.
Yes, father, in my cell.
The chaplain is in the dean now.
I shall wait. No, don't bother him just yet. Can I ask you a few questions? I've just arrived from the province. All I know is from the papers. Can you tell me, why did he murder the man?
It seems the fellow, the victim, annoyed the prisoner's girl once. During the trial, the prisoner testified that he was not a jealous person by temperament, but that when this other fellow went to extreme laying his hands on her, he vowed revenge and killed him.
But was that a sufficient reason to give him the death penalty?
Many other circumstances aggravated his case. For one thing, the murder was deliberate. It was done in the evening, and he purposely got drunk.
What weapon did he use?
A knife, about a foot long. It pierced the man's heart.
Pablo used to be so afraid of a knife.
The prisoner afraid of a knife?
Oh, I'm talking about the time you were here.
He pleaded guilty.
How strange, if I could only help you.
Too late now, less than an hour.
This girl.
What girl?
The girl you mentioned. The one Pablo killed the man for.
She's the one out there, wearing a black dress.
I can understand how Pablo in the death penalty.
But you see, he had previous convictions. Estafa, disorderly conduct, assault against constituted authority.
Estafa too?
A year ago, he forged a check for 200,000 pesos. He was an inveterate gambler, you know.
I didn't know.
You should see him now. You're allowed 5 minutes.
Yes, thank you.
A visitor, Mr. Gonzalez.
Thank you. Pablo! Don't you remember me? Andres! We were childhood friends, remember?
Ah, yes, I remember.
You used to push me into the river. Remember? Whenever we play near the bridge, have you forgotten?
No, Andres. You haven't forgotten. I only wish we were children again. We were happy then. We weren't we? You're the only friend who has come to see me. The others, my so-called friends, I haven't seen them since the trial.
They're probably busy.
Yes, too busy evading me, but you're coming. Andres, it's a complete surprise to me. I mean, I didn't expect you.
I arrived from Isabela yesterday. I came to Manila on business. I knew nothing about this until I read the newspaper last night.
I'm glad you came, Andres.
Pablo, there's a young lady outside. She should have come in first. But when she saw me near the door, she turned to me and told me to go ahead first. Is she your wife?
No. We're to be married when it's time.
Pablo, just a suggestion. Why don't you the girl outside?
Yes.
Have you thought of marrying her?
No.
Why not?
And destroy her future?
If you love her,
I do. No, I can't marry her now.
Does she love you?
That's Jessie. She does. I've been very selfish all my life.
She wouldn't care.
Maybe not now, but later, she'll regret it. Why make her the widow of a murderer?
Your mother's still alive?
Yes.
Is she here?
I hope not.
I understand. It's the best, I suppose.
You're mistaken, Andres. I hope never see her again.
Your own mother? But...
There's a man who's just seeing you, but he has no pass.
Did he give his name?
Yes, Simeon Sereno.
I don't want to see him.
Somebody you know?
He's one of my companions from the past who dragged me to the gallery.
Time is up, Mr. Prospe.
Pablo.
Thank you, Andres. I'm happy to die, knowing that at least I have a friend.
Goodbye.
Mr. Gonzalez, you wish to rest a little?
Rest now? A whole eternity to rest in the garden?
Do you mind to leave us alone? In the papers.
I didn't want to see you. You're partly to blame for my being here.
Don't be too hard on me, Pablo.
You taught me many evil things I've learned.
I regret it deeply.
Your regret? Will it save me from the chair?
If I can do something.
What can you do now?
You say I taught you many evil things.
That's true.
But I too had been taught, in my younger years, you had a friend.
You pretended to be my friend?
I've always been your friend, Pablo.
That's why I suppose you never came to see me during the trial.
How should I have known you wanted to see me? I didn't dare.
You were my closest friend, the one I trusted most. We were partners in drinking, gambling, and women. And that doesn't merit the word friendship?
True, Pablo. And yet, I think you're being unfair to me.
Unfair?
You have a mother. You are lucky to have one.
You never told me this, Simlo.
Each one of us carries a secret in his heart, which he can't reveal to anyone.
To have a mother? How sweet and beautifully consoling it must be. Yes. How wonderful it must be.
She's still alive?
Then... Anne, do not miss it, Simeon.
I'm leaving for Palawan tomorrow.
Palawan?
Yes. I have a job at the leper colony.
Among the lepers?
Among the lepers, I met a nice and fine girl 2 months ago.
You love her, Simeon?
Yes, and I want to expiate my past.
But why go to that extreme?
Great trials demand great expiations.
Forgiveness. I see you're better than that.
No, Pablo. I'm no better than you are.
I'm worse.
But to this girl, I owe the change.
I was spiritually and morally dead. And she brought me back to life.
We've never been so close to each other as we are now.
Now we can part. Not with bitter reproaches and resentment, but with complete understanding.
For the first time in my life, I know what real love is. The deep silent affection, the quiet understanding, the feeling of gentle gratitude, the sense of being alive. Yes, alive. Neither a mother's nor a woman's love I have known. Early in life, I sold my mind with unworthy thoughts, my mouth with drink and dirty language, my heart polluted with petty desires, my hands with stealing, gambling, and now murder. And then you came, Christina. You came into my sordid, lonely life and cleansed my mind and soul and brightened my world until that night.
Why? Oh God, why? If only I hadn't been walking alone that night.
When you told me the next morning how that fellow had tried to rape you, I forgot myself, I forgot you, I forgot everything. I only knew I had to wipe away the insult.
But why with blood? Pablo, you shouldn't have.
With blood? Yes, because it was the only way that insult had to be wiped away with blood. If we get married now, what can I offer to you? Nothing. Premature widowhood with the name of a murderer.
What do I get? Widowhood? Yes, but also the assurance of your wife. And my faithful little brother for all these memories. I wish there had been more. But still memories, such as virtuous memories.
After I am, after this is over, you forget me.
You shouldn't be able to forget. Pablo?
Someday you should meet a better fellow who can offer you a better future. You'll be glad. You didn't marry me. That's good.
It's nearly time, my son.
Father, this is Christina. Could we?
Yes.
Could you marry us? Now, it's the last favor I've asked you, Father. Could you?
But...
Yes! I know I'm going to die in a few minutes.
We love each other, Father.
Have you known each other long?
7 months.
But at this moment...
I want to marry him. Even at this moment.
Are you sure? We shall need 2 witnesses.
My tia Chideng is outside. Are you sure, Christina, you want this?
Sure than ever.
Thank you.
do you want?
I want to eat.
What for? To offer me your sympathy? Please, I don't need it. You didn't try to see me during the trial.
I couldn't. I was ashamed.
Ashamed? And aren't you ashamed of it here now?
Have you never mothered, Pablo?
The woman I used to call mother died. But after father's death, she lived with Marco's neighbor. I don't hate you. My feelings for you are what would I feel for a stranger.
I have left him. I left Marcos for good.
And you saw you came here to feel pride in your work?
Father, I don't understand.
If I'm here now, if I'm condemned to the chair, it's because of you.
Me?
Yes. You, have you ever been a mother to me? Did you give me any care or attention? Is it true that you spent all of your time gambling while you left me with Tia today when after father's death? Where is our gambling?
I fed you, clothed you.
And you thought you had done your duty? And you thought you had bringing me in this world? Your work was finished and that's all you got?
What did you want me to do, Pablo?
Did you ever correct my fault?
I already tried.
And did you ever teach me to fear God? Tia Chetan taught me some prayer. I quickly ran away. And my fault became happy. And my bad habit enslaved me.
I was enslaved. Trying to understand. My son.
Son? You dare me call your son? After father's death? I was 10 then. You lived with Marcos' neighbor.
I left with you.
And may I know why?
When I read your sentence a few weeks ago, I realized I have done wrong.
In the meantime, what have you done to me? You broke my ideas. You tore away my faith. You filled me with bitterness.
Pity?
You never had any for me. You sent me out of this world without faith, without actors, without dream. I wander, alone and lonely, without a home, until I met Christina, the girl I've just married.
Married?
And now that I'm about to die, I wish to have my own mother.
How to? Help me, my son!
Tears? How can your tears move me now when I'm drowning?
Then,
She wanted you. When you're 11, that was the time I met Marco. The yesterday I knew about my unhappy marriage with your father.
She knew and never told me.
I told you everything. Now come tell me if you dare.
If I could believe you, I would ask you to take care of Christina for me. But it's impossible. It's too late.
Yes, son. I'll be taking care of her. I'll be a real mother for her. What I haven't been to you.
If I could die with the word mother on my lips, if I could call you mother, God in heaven, why can't I call you mother?
Time's up. The officials are reaching your cell.
Not yet! Not yet!
We must start, Pablo.
If you wish to see your wife.
My wife? Oh, Christina. Yes. No, never mind. Why hurt her more? I'm afraid to die, Father.
Don't doubt God's mercy. His mercy is as well and as deep as the ocean.
Father, do you hear my confession? Let's go.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
It's all over. His last words were. His last words.
Yes.
Christina. Tia.
Was that all?
And mother. He whispered like a prayer. The word mother twice.
Mother? Twice?